Good morning, everybody, and Happy New Year. I'm sorry I can't be with you in person today, but here I am up on the big screen. Let us pray. Lord, transform us by your love, that we may know and do your will, that we may live and work to your praise and glory, through Christ, the King of glory, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end. Amen. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Heavenly Father, in our worship, help us to sing your praise, confess our sins, hear your word, and bring our prayers to you. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Morning has broken like the first morning. Blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Praise for the singing, praise for the morning, praise for the springing, fresh from the world. Sweet the rains new fall, sunlit from heaven, like the first dew fall on the first grass. Praise for the sweet the wet garden sprung in completeness where his feet pass.
We look to God for forgiveness, knowing that we have often grieved him through our failures and sins, for turning away from you and ignoring your will for our lives. Father, forgive us. For behaving just as we wish, without thinking of you or other people. Father, forgive us. For failing you, our families and friends, not only by what we do, but also by our thoughts and words. Father, forgive us. For letting ourselves be drawn away from you by temptations in the world about us. Father, forgive us. May the God of love bring us back to himself, forgive us our sins, and assure us of his love. In Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
We will now declare our faith and trust in God. Do you believe and trust in God the Father, source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist? We believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us, and rose again? We believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world? We believe and trust in him. This is the faith of the church. This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Today's reading is taken from Matthew 2, verses 1 to 12. The Magi visit the Messiah. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose, and we have come to worship him." When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Messiah was to be born. "Bethlehem in Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet has written. But you in Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least amongst the rulers of Judah, but out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel." When Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared, he sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me, so that I too may go and worship him." After they heard the king, they went on their way. And the star they had seen when it rose ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
People will sometimes comment that Christmas is all about the children, or that Christmas isn't the same without children. I would certainly agree that the level of excitement that will have happened in a household with children this Christmas probably outstripped the excitement levels of an adult-only household. But I would always want to gently push back and say that Christmas is not just about the children. It's not just about the excitement of Father Christmas or presents under the tree. The celebration of Christmas, which as a church goes on way beyond the opening of the last present, is about so much more. It's about the wonder of God incarnate. It is about the gift that Jesus Christ, the Word, was and is to the world. And yet, it is still about children, or rather, who children will become. The shepherds and the wise men were all prompted in different ways to look for a child. The shepherds were told by the angels to look for a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger. The wise men were prompted to follow a star to find a child. Neither of these groups of men went looking for a baby that they could coo over, or a child that could make them laugh or entertain them. Rather, they went looking for a child because of who he would become. The shepherds went looking for the child because they were told that he would be the saviour, the Messiah, The wise men went searching for the child because they had seen a sign in the form of a star that signalled that the King of the Jews had been born. Even Herod sent others to look, not because the young child was a problem for him, but because of who that child would grow up to be, the Messiah. The celebration, or in the case of Herod, the fear of the child Jesus, was not because of what he did in his younger years, what he did in the manger in Bethlehem, or what he did when the wise men found him, but it was about what this child Jesus was going to do. It was about the promised future. It was a new beginning which would fundamentally change everything. The birth of a child which would change the world and God's relationship with the world forever. St. John captured this change in the very first chapter of his gospel. To all who receive him, Jesus, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. The child born in Bethlehem would give others the power to become children. Children of God. This wasn't to be a gift of everlasting youthful looks or immaturity or even boundless energy. This was a chance to start again, to be born again, not a physical rebirth, but a spiritual rebirth, not of blood or the will of the flesh or the will of man, but a chance to be born again through God, a chance to become children of God. The Christ child gave all of us the chance to become children again, the chance to become beloved children of God. And this is something to truly celebrate. We celebrate the gift of one child. We remember the celebration and gifts brought by the shepherds and the wise men. But we celebrate too the chance that we have to become children, children of God. And as with the child Jesus, it is about what we are to grow to become. The child Jesus grew and fulfilled his destiny. He was the Messiah, the one who had been promised for many, many years. The potential and the destiny which the shepherds and the wise men celebrated and worshipped as they greeted the child Jesus was fulfilled as he grew. As we are given the gift of becoming children of God by the Christ child, how do we respond? Who are we meant to be? As children of God, how do we make our Heavenly Father proud of us? How do we grow to reach our full potential? How does a child grow to become an adult? Well, this is why Christmas doesn't stop this week. This is why Christmas doesn't end, because we pack away the tinsel and the trees going back in their boxes for another year. As children of God, it is our task to continue to grow, continue to mature, continue to discover more and more about what it means to be a child of God. And this is not a quick task, but is a lifelong task of seeking, learning and growing every day of the year, not just for the 12 days of Christmas. The Christ child grew to become a man and to fulfill all that God asked him to do. As children of God, we are called to do the same, to grow and to fulfill all that God asks us to do. Christmas is very much about children. It's about a child being born in a stable, about people coming to worship him. And it's about each one of us who are given the chance to become children of God. As the trimmings and trappings of Christmas get put away for another year, let us not put away the Christ child. Let us not forget the gift of being children of God, and instead commit to strive and grow each day of this year as we continue to journey with the Christ child into 2021 and beyond. Amen.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, born an outcast and refugee in weakness and frailty, as we rejoice today, hear our prayers for all those who have no cause for celebration. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the hungry and the homeless, the poor and the unemployed, the oppressed and the exploited, the lonely and downhearted. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the sick and the dying, the sorrowful and the bereaved, victims of violence and war, all whose lives have been shattered by tragedy and disaster. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus Christ, born to set your people free, come again in our world, bringing reconciliation where there is division, and comfort where there is sorrow, hope where there is despair, and confidence where there is confusion. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Come and bring light where there is darkness, and love where there is hatred, faith where there is doubt, and life where there is death. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus Christ, come again to our world and bring that day nearer when your kingdom will come and your will be done. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Amen. Let us join together in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. And a final prayer. Almighty God, we thank you for helping us to worship you. Be with us, Lord, as we go out into the world. May our lives as well as our worship be always pleasing in your sight, for the glory of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
finish this morning's worship with the grace. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen. Thank you ever so much, everybody, for joining me, and I hope to see you all next week. Bye-bye.